welcomes you. We want to welcome all of our dignified officials that we have here, all of our pulpit guests. We're glad to have you here. We would like to extend you all a prodigal son of welcome. Luke 15 and 20 said, and he rose and he came to his father. But when he was yet a great way off, his father saw him and had compassion and ran and fell on his neck and kissed him. His father was so glad to see him. And we are just as glad to see you all. Some of you all we have not seen since last year when we had the anniversary service. Some of you we haven't seen at all. But we want you to know we're really glad to have you here to help us celebrate our pastor and wife of 42 years. Luke 15 and 22 said, but the father said to his servant, bring forth the best robe and put it on him and put a ring on his hand and shoes on his feet. Elder First Lady Riley, we want to celebrate you with the best that we have.
Amen.
Because you know you have been really laborers for the Lord. Luke 15 and 23 said, and bring hither a fatted calf and kill it, and let us eat and be merry. Saints, a delicious meal has been prepared in our newly renovated kitchen, in which we now have a lot more room for you to sit back, relax, get comfortable, and enjoy being here with us. These two have tremendously added to the church from the beginning of them coming here. Now that all that has been said, we pray that you feel free to celebrate them with your presence, love, songs, gifts, and the word of God. Church, we're glad that you're here, and we welcome you just as the Father welcomed the prodigal son.
Amen.
Now, let me say
community. Way out of here, before I said it, first my husband and I were saying, oh, score. Then we said, wait a minute, how much is the score?
Family been here, they have shown us nothing but but godly women. Amen. I truly thank God for them, amen, coming under his leadership. Amen. I know on last year, you know, they asked me to do expression. Amen. I decided to write a poem for them. So this year I decided to do the same thing. Amen. I wrote a poem for you all. Amen. You all pray for me. Y'all gonna pray for me? Amen. This poem is entitled, What Our Pastor and First Lady Need. Amen. 42 faithful years of fighting a good fight. It's now time for us as members to help make their fight a little lighter. In this daily walk with God, just to make it a little further, they need both you and I, just like they need one another. Like a daughter needing her mother, or like a son who needs his father. They need the prayers of the righteous when things seem to get a little harder. Remember Moses and the battle with Amalek? He became so weak, his hands, he could not lift. But Aaron and Hur were there, one on his left and on his right. And as long as they held up his hands, Israel were yet winning the fight. So they need us to be faithful, loyal, and helpful members, working year-round, not just in November. They need us to be patient, not members who always complain, telling them how to do their jobs. Now you know this is just a shame. We need to be understanding, especially when visions are not the same. God has appointed him pastor. Let's just stay in our own lanes. And let's help make things easier. Help lighten up their loads. And know that in doing so, blessings will overflow. So Jerusalem, stand with me. And let's help them to succeed by being the best that we can be. That's what our pastor and first lady need.
Hey y'all. In our church, y'all, in our church, turn to turn back, our pastor be cursed. your power tonight.
Thank God for Elder Riley Jr. Yes!
missionary Riley. Them my folks. I love them folks. They've been with me by my side ever since I've been sick.
Yeah.
You know, Sister Riley came and told me, Sister Valley, she said, Sister Foster, you ain't going nowhere. She said, just hold on. Yeah. So I'm standing here today.
Yeah.
Are they great speakers?
Yeah.
Everybody a good speaker. I thank God, you know, that's my father's word. When Elder Riley came, I learned what it really means to live holy.
Yeah.
He taught us those things. Praise God. Are they called of God?
Amen. Amen.
Are they prayer warriors?
Yes.
Do they believe God can do just what he said?
Yes.
Praise God. And I'm not going to say much else, but I just thank God. God is worthy, saints, of the glory. He's worthy of honor. And he's worthy of the praise. So just give him the glory and praise for what he is.
So excited when I heard that he was going to be here. He want to get ready for the word of God.